Okay, our next subject is about something very interesting. Now, imagine you're going to buy a car, right? So, what are you going to do? Where are you going? Nakumat? Mm-hmm. No. So, where are you going? Tell me.
You're going to shop around.
Yes, shop around.
Yeah, look at beautiful cars in the market.
Exactly.
The prices of the model.
Yes, prices, models.
Mm-hmm. And the year, that kind of thing.
Okay, so you have certain expectations because you know what you want. You want maybe a four-wheel drive or a pickup truck or a minibus or whatever you want. Whatever it is, you're going to buy. And you're going to find, you check the price, you check if the condition is okay, as far as you can check if the condition is okay. And then what about the seller, the one who's selling? What's he doing? He says, this is the car. If you want it, take it. And then you take the keys, drive away, and then buy?
Yes, first to tell you about the car he's selling, mm-hmm. is to give you the positive signs about the commodity you're buying and the quality that is in the market. And of course, he has to know the profit margin that he's selling you at so that all the things come to profit margin.
Yes, he wants to make a profit, so he has to set a price. And what he expects is that you are going to pay that price for that car, right? So you're taking the car outside, you expect this thing is working. If I do this, I should hear the engine. Right, and then it should be driving, okay? And the seller expects you to pay. Simple, simple as that. Now, we're here in a training for the next 3 days, and to avoid all kind of disappointments, I would like to know what you expect from me. I think that's important. I mean, if you say, I hope we're going to make all kind of paintings, which is on the wall there, I have to disappoint you because that's not what we're going to do. But it's better to know it now than Friday afternoon and then say, oh, this was a bad training, you know, I just wasted my time. So I think it's very good to talk about the expectations both parties have. So, okay, help me out. What are your expectations? What do you expect from me?
Ideas.
Okay, good. That's one. Tell me more. What else?
Knowledge.
Good. Anything else?
Advice.
Chris. Advice. Okay, advice. I come to you. Advice. And then there was, I have to see, Crispin. Sorry?
I expect many things, but for now, one.
Yes.
From this training, I'll be able to acquire some skills and links.
Links to?
According to what I'm doing.
Okay, good. So skills, that's one. Links. I just write down what you said, to what I'm doing. Okay? Then we know what we're talking about. Okay, to learn what I don't know. This could take long, this training, right? Yeah. So to learn. Okay, so it's about how can I use it in my daily work? Yes? Is that a good description if I write that down? Okay. Okay, so the expectation is actually how can I make a business plan with the people I work with, or
the business plan, and the implementation of that business plan.
Aha. Okay. So how it will work out in practice. Okay. So that's some kind of a follow up after this training. Because you're going to work with the kids you work with, the young people. They make their business plan, and then it's the next step. Okay, good. How should I write that down? Just short, so it fits in here. Follow up? Yeah, follow up. That's the right. So it's about how to make it sustainable, how to make the entrepreneurship sustainable.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what are the boundaries of social entrepreneurship? Is that right? So it's about sustainability, right? How to make business sustainable? Should I put it that way? Okay. Okay, certificate of participation. Okay. Yeah, well, it's okay, it's okay. I write it this way here because... Okay, so you to be able to train other people afterwards. Okay, that's good. So I'm going to take up this one. So you're the ones who are buying this car now, and I'm the one who's selling the car. So I do have my expectations too. Okay? So first of all, respect. Simple as that. Respect for yourself, respect for each other, respect for the building here, the material we're working with, for everything. I mean, this is the basis of the whole life, I think. If you have respect, it's no problem at all, right? No worries. Then another one. Look what I write down. Be here on time. Paul, this is going to be a great test for you these 3 days.
No, I keep time.
Good. Should I write there, be here on the right time then? This is a very, I think this is a very important item. Be there on time. I mean, imagine you have your business plan. You have your plan here in your head and in your heart. And this is really what you want. You walk to that bank, the KCB or whatever it will be, Barclays, whatever. You walk in there, you have this conversation with this man who might decide if you're going to get this loan or not to start your business, and then you show up 20 minutes late. What do you think is going to happen? There are always people who are on time. And then you want to start your training, and you're like, okay, well we're not complete. We're waiting for some other people. So the people who are on time think, hey, what the heck, tomorrow I can be late. They're waiting anyway. So what's the use of being on time? Right? And the people who come in late, they say, hey, they've been waiting for me. No problem. Tomorrow I'll be late again. So, you know, it's never going to change if you keep acting that way. So what I do normally in trainings is, if we say 8:30 we start, I start at 8:30. So if somebody walks in at 9 or 9:30 or I don't know what time, okay to me. Join in, sit down. It's okay, you're welcome. But you have missed something. And if you talk about respect, it's not respectful to yourself. Imagine you walk into that bank, it's 20 minutes late, and the guy who sits there waiting for you is gone already because he said, well, 20 minutes, why? I'm not waiting for you. Means you're not going to get the loan, you're not going to start the business. What about your future? What about the future of your kids, of your family? You know, it's in the little details. I think it's important. Anyway, another one is this one. Participate actively. That's no problem here, I think, is it? And last but not least, have fun. Let's have fun. It's so easy. We can do both ways. We can sit here with long faces, or we can have fun. Whatever you choose. I choose to have fun. It makes work much easier. Okay? So, This is one, and this is the other. I'm going to stick them to the, put them here right now. Good. So, what do we have now? We have an agreement, if we agree. So, let me see. How to make business sustainable. That's what we're going to talk about. Ideas, no problem. What are the boundaries of social entrepreneurship? Nice topic. We're going to talk about that. Knowledge, advice, skills, links to what I'm doing, okay, to learn what I don't know, how to use this in daily work, follow-up. I'm not sure about this. Who mentioned follow-up? Whose part was it? Was yours? Okay. I think we can talk about follow-up. I'm not sure if we can support in follow-up, which might come from Tangaza, I don't know, but we have to discuss that. Good. How to make entrepreneurship sustainable, all right. Certificate of participation, we talked about that, Rafael. To be able to train other people. Okay. I think I can deliver these things. So I am going to put my sign here. So can you stick to what's there written on the right one here in the green? Respect, be here on time, participate actively, and have fun. What do you think? Can we agree on that? So we have a contract now? Okay. If you can stick to this, I want to invite you here to put your sign on here so we have a contract. Is that okay with you? Okay. On behalf of the whole group. Look at that. That's a piece of art, then. Wonderful. Thank you very much. So now we have a contract. Now let's step out of this and look at the process. Why are we doing this? Why are you going to do this with your group of people you work with? Why would you do this?
It's a sign of commitment.
Yes, exactly. It's commitment. Creating commitment. The good thing is you make the rules, most of them. And it's clear from the start what we expect from each other. So we can avoid all kind of disappointments. On the other hand, it's also like, if somebody's not showing respect anymore, you can always point to this contract and say, hey, what did we agree on? We were talking about respect. What are you doing now? This doesn't match. Or somebody's being late. He said, hey, we have a contract. You're not delivering what we agreed on. So what we're going to do now? And give them examples, like turning the things around. Now imagine you're the director of a company, and then there is an employee coming late. But he's expecting you to pay the full wages. But every day he's late. So what are you going to tell this guy? That's not what you agreed on. So you have to stick to that, right? So that's why how you can use this, okay? I always stick this to the wall during the whole training program so everybody can see it anytime. At the end of the training, we will look to hold this through the whole list and see if we really can skip all these things, if we really have been talking about that, okay?